Today, we're going to look at the new JMS client in Spring Boot 4. Now, JMS stands for Java Messaging Service, and it's been around for a long time. Quite frankly, if you were going to start a new project, you would probably reach for another technology. But here's the hard truth, friends. We don't always get to create these fun and exciting greenfield projects. A lot of times we are working on existing applications, and a lot of those existing applications in the enterprise may still use JMS. So this is a really nice addition. Now this follows suit to the REST client and the JDBC client that we got in Spring Boot 3.2, and it gave us this nice, fluent, easy to understand API for working with those technologies, following up on the template pattern. Similar to that, we had the JMS template. Now we're introducing the JMS client, giving you that nice fluent API. So what we're gonna do is take a look at a couple things, and then we'll build out a simple application using the new JMS client. So I'm gonna jump over to my screen here. If you wanna learn more about JMS and specifically the JMS client, the Spring Boot reference documentation is great. I will leave a link to this section in the description below. I also have a full repo for some of the things we're gonna go through today and more. You'll go down, you'll see, you'll learn about JMS, JMS compatible products, how to get started with this. I give a bunch of messaging patterns in the final repo. We'll probably just go through one or two of those today. But this is a really good repo if you're working with JMS. So to get started, we're going to head over to start.spring.io. I'm going to create a new Java project using Spring Boot 4.0. I'm going to say dev.danvega. We'll just call this orders because I'm working with orders. And as far as dependencies goes, I'm just going to pick web. And I also need some JMS technology. So I'm going to choose Spring for Apache ActiveMQ Artemis. That is messaging. And that's really all we need. From there, we can generate a new project. This will download a zip. You can open it up in whatever IDE or text editor you're most efficient in. For me, that's going to be IntelliJ. We have what we need. Let's write some code. All right, so here we are in IntelliJ. I just want to talk about something really quick because I get a lot of comments that say, Dan, can you please use dark mode? I'm going to use light mode and dark mode. I prefer light mode when I'm presenting. When I'm coding, I use dark mode a lot. And here I am in the newest version of IntelliJ IDEA 2025.3, and they have these new islands theme, which I particularly like, so I'm going to use that today. But please stop commenting on the videos about which mode I'm using. Sorry, we're gonna use them both, and I happen to like light mode for presenting. All right, with that, we can get started. I have a normal application here. Let's just make sure we start up. And before we get going, and everything looks good. And so the first thing I'm gonna do is we're gonna take a look at the pom.xml. I just realized I probably should have selected Docker Compose support because we're bringing in Artemis. So make sure you select Docker Compose and you'll get this little bit in your pom.xml. And you'll also get a compose.yaml, and the compose.yaml will set up these services for us so that we don't have to go ahead and set up Artemis on our own. So I'm gonna create a file here, compose.yaml. Paste some stuff in here and we'll get our JMS demo here. We have some ports here, one for the web console, one for JMS. And if we want to open up the web console, we see we have admin and not allowing anonymous users to log in. Okay, so with that, I think we have everything you need. Let's make sure Docker Desktop is running, and it is. So we should be able to restart this application and make sure that something starts up. Oh, no, no, no. So JMS Ditto, that is already in use. That's okay. I'm over on my Docker Desktop here. I'm just going to get rid of that container. And we'll go ahead and try and run this again. All right, debugging in the wild, this is good. So container JMS started on 8080. We should be good to go. Okay, so we have kind of our infrastructure in place and we wanna go ahead and set up a couple things. So the first thing I'm gonna do is start with the idea of an order. So we're working with orders in this application. I'm gonna come over here and create a new Java class called order. This will be a record. And we'll just copy pasta here. We have an order ID, a customer ID, an amount, status, timestamp, and then we have an order status that we're using inside of here. So I can just kind of add it here. So pending processing, completed or failed. Okay, so that's our order. Now we can start with an order messaging service. So let's come in here and say new Java class, order messaging service. And this is going to be a class. This is going to be an @service annotation. And we'll get a couple of things in here. I'm going to start with a logger. This is an IntelliJ live template that I use to just kind of type this out so I don't have to type it. And then we'll ask for the JMS client. So private, final, JMS client, and JMS client. So that is going to get auto-wired in for us. We can say add a constructor parameter, and now we have a JMS client. And this is what's new in Spring Boot 4. Again, in previous applications, you can use the JMS template, but if you're on 4, go ahead and reach for the JMS client because it is nice. It has a nice Fluent API. So I'm going to start with a method here. Let's say send simple order. And this is going to take in one of those orders. We'll call it order. And I'm going to go ahead and log some info out here. Sending order. Let's just say, yeah, that's fine. And what I want to do is use the JMS client. So now, just like the previous clients with the REST client and the JDBC client, now when I say JMS client dot, I get this nice Fluent API. So the first thing I want to do is set up a destination. I don't have a destination yet, so I want to go ahead and set that up. So I'm going to come back over to resources and to my application.yaml file. And I'm going to set a few things up. Let's go ahead and copy this and we'll paste that in here. And we're just saying, hey, Artemis, the mode is native. Here's the URL, username, password, and JMS template. We're going to set a default destination, which is demo queue. We actually don't need this. That's the default. And then we're setting the debug for JMS, the login level. So once that's in place, I still don't have this this order queue, but I'm going to go ahead and set one up here. I'm going to say we want to send things to the order queue. And then I'm going to go ahead and send, and we're just going to send the order. Ah, that's such a nice, easy to use API. I love it. Okay. So we have this service, but we need to use this service. So I'm going to create a new Java class. I'm going to call this the order controller. And in the order controller, this is going to be a REST controller. We're going to set a request mapping of slash orders, slash API, slash orders. And then I'll get a couple things here. Let's get a logger for this. And then what I'm going to do is bring in that order messaging service, and we'll get that through constructor injection. And now we can create an endpoint to basically consume an order. So I'm going to say this is a post mapping. We'll have a bunch in here, so I'll just call this simple. And this is going to return a response entity of string, and we'll say send simple order, sure. And what we're going to do is use that messaging service. So what did we call that? Order messaging service dot send simple order, and we'll pass in the order. We need an order here, Dan. We'll take that in the request body. That will be an order, and we'll call that order. Okay. And what we're going to do is return this response entity dot okay. I want to say order sent. And we'll say order.orderID, okay? I don't know why we're getting that there, but that looks good. Okay, so now I have a simple endpoint that I can basically start up my application, hit an endpoint slash API slash orders with the type post, send in an order, and then we will go off and send this to the order messaging service, send a simple order, and the JMS client will go ahead and send this. So what we need is a way to test this. So I'm going to start with IntelliJ has this HTTP client. Again, you can do this from any client. You can do it from Postman or curl or HTTPy. I'm just going to use the built-in HTTP client. So I'm going to say store.http, and we're just going to copy in a simple one here. So let's do this. So localhost slash 8080 API orders simple. This is a post. Here is the order that we're going to send in. So let's go ahead and rerun our application. Okay, everything looks good. Now let's try and send a post using our client. Yep, and we see that we have an error. So let's go in here and see what it says. Okay, I cannot convert object of type dev.danvega.orders.order to JMS message. So supported message payloads are a string, byte array, map, etc. So what we need to do is provide a way to handle this. So we're gonna create our own message converter here. Now this is nothing new. We need to be able to translate to and from an order. So I'm gonna create a Java class. I'm gonna call this the Jackson JMS message converter. And that is going to implement the message converter. Yep, that one. This is going to be a component. You need to implement some methods here, so from and to. So let's go in here. Now we are on Spring Boot 4, so we're using Jackson 3, so we could take advantage of the JSON mapper. All right, so I'm going to say private final JSON mapper. I am going to not get this from Spring because I'm going to kind of customize this a little bit. So let's do this. Let's say JSON mapper.builder.build, sure. But we are going to also say find and add modules. All right. So now that we have our JSON mapper, we can use that. I don't know why I thought I called this JSON mapper. So let's do that and that. And with that, we can go ahead and override these methods. I'm not gonna type these out. It's not that interesting. But what we can do is say to message and from message. And what we'll do is we'll take in the object and the session and we'll say, hey, go ahead and write this as a string. It's just a way to convert that object to and from an actual message here. So let's say, there's the problem. We want this message converter. Okay, that looks a little bit better. All right, so now that we have this in place, let's see if we can't rerun this application. Go back to our HTTP client and try to send a post. And we get a 200. Everything looks okay. Order sent, ORD1. So we have an order sent. Now we need to receive one. But let's take a look at how we can do this a couple different ways. One, I have this compose.yaml that says, hey, there's a web console at HTTP localhost 8161. So let's go ahead and check that out. And remember, the username for this is admin. So I'll go ahead and log in here. Close all this fun stuff. So we have our status, we have connection, sessions. If we go down to queues, remember we sent this off to the order queue. So we see this order queue here and we see one in here. So a message ID, priority of 4. If we go ahead and click on this, we can go in and see the details for this particular order. So order ID 1, customer 123, the amount, etc. So we see that we were able to come in here and view that particular order that's on that queue. But let's take a look at another way that we can handle this. So I am going to stop this. Let's go ahead and close some of this out. And I'm gonna create a new Java class called the order receiver. This is a class. We'll go ahead and mark it with @component so it gets picked up. We'll ask for a logger again. And we'll go ahead and say private final, I cannot spell ever, static final string, we'll call this the order queue. Sure, that looks good. And now what we can do is use the JMS listener. So we've used this before. I'm saying, hey, I want to go ahead and listen on the destination, which is going to be that order queue, so order queue. And now I can create a method to listen for those orders that are on that queue. So we'll say receive order, and then I'll just go ahead and log this out that we received the order. So let's go ahead and run the application again. I'm gonna go back over to my HTTP client. I'm gonna go ahead and execute this, and it looks like that went through. And if we go into our logs here, our console, we see that we received the order, and there is that order that we sent off. So pretty cool there, just a nice test of both the new JMS client and using a JMS listener here. Now let's go ahead and maybe add one more kind of pattern here. So I'm gonna go back over to my order messaging service and just show off a little bit more. So we'll kind of copy and paste this in. And now I have a send priority order. So again, we get this nice Fluent API. We are sending to that same destination, but now we can configure some quality of service settings, right? Like, hey, I want with time to live to be 5 minutes. I want to set a priority. Maybe this is a very high priority. I want to go ahead and set delivery delay to 1 second, and then I want to go ahead and send this off. So again, if you come down in here, you can see the API for this. You can jump into the JMS client, but there's a lot of things that we can go ahead and send. So I have this send priority order. I'm going to need a way to do that in my controller. So let's go back to our controller here, and I'll go ahead and set up another post. We called this something different. And so we're taking in an order, and now we're sending a priority order. So priority order sent with QoS settings. Here's the order ID. All right, so now let's see if we can go ahead and set that. So I'm going to grab my demo 2 and go over to my HTTP client. And here's this one. So localhost 8080/API/orders/priority. And here is a new order. So order 2 is priority. So let's go ahead and restart this application. And with it set, I'm going to go ahead and run this one. We get a 200, which is good. And then we received order here. Again, this is order 2. And here is everything that we had. So there you have it, the JMS client in Spring Boot 4, just a nice, easy to use Fluent API following up with the REST client and the JDBC client. Big fan of this. And as I said before, you probably are not reaching for JMS if you're building out a new service, right? But we live in a world where we have to support a lot of enterprise applications, especially in the Java world, right? And so with JMS in place, this new JMS client is something that I believe you can use right away. Maybe not, don't go rip out existing code just to take advantage of this client, but as you're building new services on JMS, this client is really nice to use, and Spring Boot 4 will auto wire one up for you. Of course, if you need to configure your own, you can do that as well. So that's the new JMS client in Spring Boot 4. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, friends, do me a big favor, leave me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and as always, happy coding.